Hello and welcome to this online lecture on the evaluation framework and methods for economic assessment, the EVA tool, a decision tool to evaluate animal health surveillance. My name is Marie Zappey and I am an epidemiologist at CIRAD, a French Institute for International Agricultural Research for Development. My field of research is the evaluation of animal health management policies, including surveillance and control of animal and zoonotic diseases. I have worked for the past 10 years on the evaluation of animal health surveillance, both in developed and developing countries. Since 2012, I have been in charge of the evaluation work package of the European Union Risk SOAR project on the development of cost-effective surveillance strategies based on risk. This lecture has been developed in the framework of this project, and I thank you for joining it today, and I hope you will enjoy it. I expect the participants should be already familiar with the concept of animal health surveillance and evaluation, or should undertake the previous lecture, the previous courses on these topics in this Risk SOAR lecture series before engaging in this lecture. Risk SOAR is an international research project funded by the European Union from 2012 to 2015. This project has developed innovative methods to support the design and evaluation of risk-based surveillance systems for the surveillance objectives of early detection of disease, freedom from disease documentation, case detection, and the disease frequency estimation. At the end of the lecture, the participant will be aware of the rationale and challenges behind the evaluation of animal health surveillance. They will learn on how to use the EVA tool to plan an evaluation and to follow the essential steps of the process to evaluate animal health surveillance. This lecture provides information on where to find guidelines on how to plan, implement, and report on the evaluation process. However, it does not cover specific aspects of the implementation of the evaluation, such as the methods to assess the evaluation attributes, and the economic evaluation methods, which are covered in other modules of the Risk SOAR training series. I will start my presentation with an introduction of the challenges in the evaluation of animal surveillance and basic concept of the evaluation process. Then I will present the evaluation framework developed within Risk SOAR using the EVA decision tool, which is covering different aspects of the evaluation process, including how to frame and define the evaluation protocol, how to implement the evaluation, how to address the evaluation question, including economics, and how to report to decision makers on the output of the evaluation. Then I will conclude the lecture. So first, why do we do surveillance? Surveillance is about identifying diseases. So this is the iceberg paradigm. Some of the diseases are reported and some of the cases are not reported and are not detected. Passive or scanned surveillance allows to see what is at the top of the iceberg. And active surveillance allows to see a part of what is not reported, but there is always this part which will never be detected. So evaluation of surveillance allows to define corrective action to improve this passive and active surveillance, to increase the part of cases which will be detected and decrease this part which will never be detected. However, animal surveillance is a complex system which is being affected by many drivers which are not only epidemiological but also social, economical, and political. So there is a need for interdisciplinarity, especially in the evaluation process. Moreover, there is perception issues of the different point of view of the different stakeholders in the system between the state, the society, and the farmer, for which the costs and benefits of animal health surveillance are very different, and most of these costs and benefits are often not taken into consideration within the evaluation process, and especially the ones that are highlighted in red on this slide, which are the social costs and social benefits. So why do we need to evaluate? There is many reasons why we need to evaluate, and especially to plan or redesign. To ensure reaching the objective, to make sure that one surveillance system is meeting the target, to take the right corrective actions, but we also want to evaluate to advocate for changes, to demonstrate that the quality of the data generated is good, to ensure that the action have been effective, to advocate for fun or to ensure trust. So there is many reason why we are doing evaluation. So what evaluation can do? It can help the user to perform a systematic assessment against standards. It can provide degree and value of achievement, and these elements help in decision making, but also enable reflection of the different people involved in the evaluation process, and that is promoting future changes. So there is a All this aspect can influence all the technical, economic, social, and politic elements which are embedded in the complexity of the surveillance system. However, there is important aspect that should be taken into consideration, the timing and the scale. Evaluation can be done ex ante, which means during the design phase. To be formative, that means to improve the design proposal. It can be done during the implementation of the surveillance, to provide corrective action, to adjust and revise the design and redesign the surveillance. But it could also be done at the end of a surveillance process when a surveillance system is stopped, to draw lesson and inform or reflect on other or new design. So this is quite rare, but this could happen. Moreover, there is different types and level of evaluation. Someone could do an effectiveness evaluation just to understand if the system is working, to evaluate a specific technical performance of the system. Then you can do a process evaluation to try to understand why the system is working in such a way and to try to identify corrective actions. And then the higher level of evaluation is trying to understand the value of the system or component under evaluation, and to compare it against a counterfactual, to compare alternatives, and that includes the economic evaluation. That's the comprehensive evaluation. Of course, according to the type of evaluation that someone wants to do, the degree of complexity increases, and also the resources and time needed to be invested in the evaluation process. So the evaluation process could be divided into three main parts. The first part is the planning phase, which includes the fact to engage the decision makers, the need to define the object under evaluation, and the framing of the evaluation. And that phase involves the definition of the evaluation plan. The second part is the implementation, which implies the description and the analysis, so the assessments of the system and the analysis of the data. And the last part is about reporting, so a synthesis of the results and a reporting of the output to decision maker to be able to engage them in required changes. So, why did we develop a specific evaluation framework within the RiskScore project and a specific tool for it, the EVA tool? Because we did a review on the early stage of the project, a review of the existing guides, evaluation guides for animal health surveillance. As you can see, this is the list of the existing guide for health, public health, and animal health surveillance. And none of these guides would provide sufficient guidance element for comprehensive evaluation, and more especially including economic evaluation and methods to implement economic evaluation. Moreover, some of the guides were very generic and or some of the guides were too specific, as they have been mostly developed based on ad hoc application, just looking at a specific surveillance system or objective. So the objective of the RiskScore evaluation framework is to provide guidance on the evaluation process, including economic evaluation, to promote the use of this aspect in the evaluation, but also to provide a toolkit to perform the evaluation, so practical elements that would help the user on trying to understand how to implement the evaluation, which means links with existing methods and tools but also information on innovative tools that are available. Within the framework, we are also trying to provide information on the advantages and limits of choosing a different, a specific type or level of evaluation, but also in the choice of the different methods that are available to assess the different evaluation attributes. And this will provide information on the feasibility of the evaluation, but also on the strengths and limits of the evaluation, which is important in the argumentation provided at the end to decision maker to advocate for changes. It is important to emphasize here that the EVAD decision tool is not an evaluation tool. It provides guidance on how to perform the evaluation. So now I will present the framework and the tool by going through the online application of the EVAD tool. So this is the introduction page. So when someone logs into the RiskSure tool, he gets to this welcome page where you can see that the EVA tool is only one aspect of the RiskSure toolkit, which helps the user in designing surveillance and evaluating it. So this surveillance 2.0 toolkit. And the target users for this toolkit is expected to be competent and technical level users who design, implement, or evaluate surveillance strategies for infectious livestock disease within the European Union. It is likely not to be an individual, but rather a team, which has knowledge in epidemiology, surveillance, and evaluation. And in the case of economic evaluation, it will be advised that the team is supported by an economist advisor. So how is this tool build up? So first, the user needs to define the context of evaluation. So what is my situation? What is my surveillance system and my evaluation needs? And that helps framing the evaluation question. So why am I doing an evaluation? So this is a very critical aspect of the evaluation plan. As I mentioned before, evaluation has a cost. That means that the evaluation process will involve experts and resources. So the evaluation should be done for a specific reason, and especially the evaluation should be done to take action to or to advocate for changes. It should not be done just for the sake of doing an evaluation. So when the context and the evaluation question has been defined, it is possible to identify what to evaluate and how to do it to be able to address the evaluation question. So if we go back to the online EVA tool and we go to the evaluation tool section, so the tool provides information on the introduction of an introduction to evaluation of surveillance. I will get into more details. And then it takes you to the difference to the four-step process on how to plan the evaluation. So the first one is to describe the evaluation context. The second step is to select the evaluation question. The last step is to select the evaluation method, and then the tools provide a summary of the evaluation protocol. Then the tool provides also information on how to perform the evaluation and how to report on the evaluation result. So from this welcome page, you can either start the evaluation by starting the description process, or you can also get additional basic information on evaluation concept by logging into an evaluation wiki page that has been created especially and is linked to the tool to provide additional guidance and information. So you can see here, this is the welcome page of the EVA wiki space. And this wiki covers a different range of information on evaluation of animal surveillance. So basic definition, what is evaluation, information on the evaluation framework, and also the challenges that I just mentioned in animal health evaluation. But it also provides important elements on the evaluation process. So the planning, the implementation, the reporting. Essential elements also on the economic evaluation method and how to report on the evaluation. The wiki also provides information on the RiskSur EVA tool, on how the tool has been developed, who are the target users, and all the different logical aspects of the tool regarding the selection of evaluation attributes and assessment methods. And of course, there is a page which allows the user to download a specific manual on the EVA tool, and also links to important websites such as the RiskSur website or other evaluation initiative websites. So if we go back to the tool and the introduction to evaluation of surveillance, so the tool has a page on the evaluation concept, which is closely linked to the wiki space, but also link to a definition, the RiskSur glossary. That means that all the terminology that is being used in the evaluation process has been specifically defined within the RiskSur project by expert opinion. And this is the definition of the evaluation of animal surveillance, which is presented here. And then if the user clicks on any of the words, such as assessments, for example, he will get directed to the RiskSur glossary page, which provides a definition on all the important terms which are important to understand to be able to use these tools, including surveillance and evaluation terms. So then the tool provides an overview of the evaluation process, and each one of these different aspects is linked to wiki space, to a wiki page in the EVA wiki, which provide detailed information. Then the third menu in the introduction is about the economic methods. So the tools provide a short description on this page of each of the economic methods which are available at the moment, including cost analysis, cost effectiveness, cost benefit, and least cost analysis. And by clicking on each one of these method buttons, or by going directly to the EVA wiki page, the user gets more detailed information on what are the different economic methods and how to implement them, and what are the reference that have been either developed, the methodological reference who have developed the methods or applied it. And then the last section in the introduction is about the evaluation attributes. So there is 19 evaluation attributes which are displayed in the tool. So this is the attributes, the characteristic of the system, which has great influence and are very important in the evaluation process. So same thing as for the economic methods. If the user clicks on one of the attributes, you will get directed to a pop-up box which will present the specific definition of the evaluation attributes. So those definitions have been reviewed by expert opinion elicitation within the course of the RiskSur project. And each definition is linked to more information on the attributes in the wiki space. So this is about the general concept of evaluation of animal surveillance. But then when the user wants to start planning its evaluation, it goes to the first step in the tool, which is the description of the evaluation context. So this is the planning phase, and this is what the EVA tool is mainly covering on how to plan the evaluation. So first, the user will be asked to select a surveillance system. So before planning an evaluation, you need to know what you want to evaluate. So either the user goes to the surveillance system section in the tool here and selects an existing system or create a new one, or the users can also directly select a system which is already created by clicking on the top right drop list button. And here, for example, I will select the CSF Wild Board surveillance system that has been entered in the tool already. And the tool tells me that the surveillance system is now CSF Wild Board. So if we go back to the description of the evaluation context, so the user has two choices, either selecting an existing one or creating a new evaluation context. So if I want to create a new evaluation context, I get to this page where there is a list of questions which are critical to be able to frame the evaluation. And this is context questions, which are context elements, which are very important to be able to define the evaluation question. So first, the user will be asked to create a name for the evaluation, and then it will get through this series of questions about the strengths and weaknesses of the current approach that is currently being implemented, the stakeholder concerns about the approach, is the user considering alternative strategy, if the user wants to work to evaluate the system, the whole system, or only some of the components of the system. And if the user wants to work at the component level, how many components will be included in the evaluation? If the user is considering risk-based option, and if you are interested in the cost. And then if you are interested in the cost, do you know how much your system costs at the moment, or the component, and if you have a budget constraint. So on this page, the user also gets a summary display on the right side on the different elements of the surveillance system that he has selected for evaluation. So when I have created my evaluation context and saved it, so the tool tells me that the evaluation has been created successfully, then I'm taken to the second step of the definition of the evaluation plan, which is the selection of the evaluation question. And for this, there is two choices. So either to select the question from the evaluation question pick list, I will come back to this, or if the user doesn't exactly know how to define the question or what he wants to evaluate, he can go through the guidance pathway to define the evaluation question. So when getting to this guidance pathway, he will go through a series of questions which will help framing the question, and the tool will then propose to him a specific question, and the user will review if this question fits his needs. So for example, if I go through this pathway with my objective of evaluation, so at every step of the way, the user can click on this interrogation points button to get additional information on what it means, what is this step. It gets taken to the wiki space where this step is being described. So for each step, there is a specific description. Just to make sure that the user understand what are the questions and what would be the consequences of choosing one option or the other. So the first question is to try to understand at which system the user wants to perform its evaluation. So here, I am interested in evaluating a specific component of the CSF surveillance system, which is about wildboar active surveillance in wildboar. So I will click on the component level. Then the pathway will get me through a question trying to understand what is my purpose. So do I want to evaluate or do I want to redesign? So here I want to evaluate. I already have a new design. So then it will ask me if I want to look at the efficiency and or the effectiveness, if I want to evaluate the strengths and weaknesses of the system or the component, or if I want to evaluate the functional aspect that may influence its effectiveness. So at this stage, it is important to specify that you might have more than one objective for your evaluation. So maybe someone wants to evaluate the effectiveness and the functional aspect. So at this stage, you need to create two different evaluation contexts. You will need to go through the pathway again and select the two different options. You can only select one at the time. So here I want to evaluate the efficiency and the effectiveness of my component. Then the tool asks me if I want to compare it to an alternative or if I just want to assess this one single component. So I do want to compare new design with my current design. And then the tool is asking me if the components have the same objective. And this is really important because then the evaluation process is much more complex if the components does not have the same objective. For example, if I am comparing a component which is trying to do early detection and a component which is there for case finding. So in my case, they all have the same objective. And then the tool asks me on specific criteria that I am interested in, the cost and the effectiveness, the cost only, the effectiveness only, or the cost and the benefits. So again, if I am not too sure about what is the difference between benefits and effectiveness, I can go and click on this interrogation button, and I will be taken through the wiki page, which will provide more information and link to the definition of these two elements, for example. So here I am interested in the cost and effectiveness. And then the next question is about asking me if there is a target effectiveness that need to be met. And this is very relevant under the EU legislation context, where when the surveillance system is as legal requirement from the EU, you are supposed to meet a specific effectiveness target. So in my case, this is the case. And then the tool is asking me if I already know the effectiveness of my different components, or if I need to assess it. So it has not been assessed, so I will need to assess it. So I click the second option. And after this series of questions, the tool is able to guide me to this evaluation question number three, which is about assessing the cost and effectiveness of surveillance components out of two more, to determine which achieve a defined effectiveness target at least cost, knowing that the effectiveness needs to be assessed. And so I am looking at this question, and I need to reflect on it and see if it does fit my evaluation need, and in my case it does. So here the tool also provide information on what it takes to evaluate. So what are the evaluation criteria linked to this specific question? So here is effectiveness and cost. But if we look at question number four, it's only about assessing the effectiveness, for example. And it also provides information on what is the evaluation method preferred here. And in my case, it's the least cost assessment. So if I want to get more information on the meaning of this evaluation question and evaluation criteria or evaluation methods presented, I can always go to the evaluation wiki and get more detailed information. So this evaluation question list, as I mentioned before, is already accessible directly. You don't need to go through the pathway if you exactly know what you want to evaluate. So you can go through this list and you can look at this. There is 11 questions. So this is the first 5-1. And then you can see that there is another list of questions. And then you can directly pick the question that that fits your need to continue the process. So then the next step in the process, when I have defined my evaluation context, I have defined my evaluation question. I know exactly why I am doing this evaluation. Then the tool takes me to the selection of the component because I have mentioned that I want to do the evaluation at the component level. So the tool asks me to choose which component I want to include in my evaluation. So after doing that, I can move on to the next step of the process, which is the selection of evaluation attributes to assess to be able to address my evaluation question. So first, the user is taken to the page on the evaluation summary. So what is the current situation? What are the previous choice that I have made? So I've selected my surveillance system is CSF in wild boar. My evaluation name that I'm currently developing is CSF in wild boar 2. And it provides me a lot of information on what are the surveillance objectives, what is the evaluation question, again, the criteria and the method, and all the information that has been entered in the context page. And then if we scroll down this page, the tool provides the list of evaluation attributes which are relevant to be assessed to address the evaluation question. So within the RiskSER project, we have been through a series of expert opinion to assign a specific degree of relevance to each of the evaluation attributes. And this degree of relevance was dependent on the evaluation context and more especially the surveillance objective, but also on the evaluation question. So here you can see that there is few of the attributes that are classified as highly relevant, some of them as medium relevant. That means that it would be interesting to assess them if there is resources and time to do so, and some with low relevance. That means that they don't have a very important impact on the quality of the evaluation output if they are not being considered. So it is important also to understand here that the user can choose which attributes he wants to include in the evaluation plan. And that means that you can either select all the highly relevant attributes or only some of them. As I mentioned before, evaluation has a cost and it involves times and resources. So sometimes it is not possible to look at all the different elements which are important to understand the performance of the system. Okay, and it is important to know also that there is a second selection step in which is embedded in the tool by looking at the assessment methods that are available to assess these attributes. And sometimes some of the methods are not, it's not possible to implement them for some reason. And so then the selection of the attributes is also based on the fact that there is either no methods to assess them or no data to be able to do so. So this is this will be the next step. So first, I need to select the attributes that I want to include in my evaluation plan. So in my case, I'm interested in sensitivity and in cost. So that's the next step, is about looking at which methods are available, which one can I use to assess my sensitivity and my cost. So the tool takes the user to this page where the users first need to select which evaluation attributes from the list that he has selected. So here, first, I look at the sensitivity. And then the tool provides an exhaustive list of the methods that are currently available in the literature on how to measure sensitivity of animal health surveillance system. So here in the training PowerPoint, this is only an example of two methods, but it is important to mention that there is currently 14 different methods to assess sensitivity. So I did not list them all here, just so it is easier to see on the screen. So what the tool also provides is basic information on what is this method, so a basic description, but also information on the strengths and limits of the method and the data that are required to be able to use this method, and also the level of expertise. So all this information has been retrieved from the reference literature publication, which are mentioned in the last column of this table. So either these publications are about the development of the method or its application. And all this information, which has been combined here, has been sent back to the experts of each of the methods, either the one that have developed it or applied it, for validation. So at the moment, we have identified 70 different methods that are available in the literature to assess all the different evaluation attributes. And we have been able to validate 50% of them. And at the moment, so 50% of the methods are presented in the tool because they have been validated by experts. However, all the other methods and information about the methods are available in the wiki. And we are the evaluation process is ongoing to continue validating all these methods. So here, the next step for me is to choose the most appropriate method. That means that the one that I want to use according to the data I have and the expertise that I have on this method. So I am choosing the first one because I have the data and not the second one because I actually don't have the data to be able to do so. So then I need to do it for all the attributes that I have selected to be included in my evaluation. And when I've done that, I move on to the next step, which is about looking at the economic analysis techniques. So my evaluation includes an economic evaluation question. It's about trying to identify the component which is providing the most effective result at the least cost. And so the tool is giving me all the information on all the economic analysis technique that I need to use to be able to address this least cost assessment question. And that includes methods on how to do cost analysis. So there has been methods that have been developed, and same for the evaluation attributes assessment methods. The tools provide a description and also reference and links to a detailed description of the method in the wiki. And the second method is how to do a least cost assessment. And here it is provided here, and so I need to select them all. So the last, so now that I have described my context, I know why I'm doing this evaluation. I have my evaluation question. I know how I can address this question, which attributes I need to consider and how to measure them, and how can I address my economic evaluation question. So now the tool takes me to the last step of this process, providing the summary of this evaluation plan, which includes all the information about the surveillance system and the evaluation context, including the evaluation question. A summary of all the evaluation attributes that I have decided to include in my evaluation plan, including a description of the attributes and links to the evaluation wiki space, where there is a detailed description of the attribute. It also provides information on the method that I have selected to be able to assess this attribute, and also information on the economic evaluation analysis techniques that I need to run to be able to address my question. And again, with providing information to the to link to the wiki to get even more information, and link to the references. So now that I have defined my evaluation plan, first describing my context, I know why I am doing this evaluation. I have my list of evaluation attributes that I need to assess and how to assess them. I have also information on the methods to use. Then the tool provides me additional guidance on how to perform the evaluation. And that includes information on the different aspects and limits and strengths of the evaluation according to the choice I have made. So if I'm doing only a technical or a comprehensive evaluation, which include an economic question, so what would that mean in terms of interpretation of the result? But also some information on how to collect additional data for some methods if required, for example, and also some information on a specific work plan that could be followed to implement the evaluation. So this work plan has been developed within the application of the case study within the research project. And this is just an example of this work plan that takes the user through all the different steps that needs to be implemented to run the evaluation. So then the last section of the tool is providing additional guidance on how to report on the evaluation results. So after defining the evaluation plan, I have implemented my evaluation, I have my results, but sometimes it could be quite tricky to interpret, or I'm not too sure on how to report this to decision makers to make sure that they will understand it and they will acknowledge my result to implement changes. So here, in the tool, we provide some basic elements and useful information on how to improve these reporting steps and how to present the evaluation result in the best way that decision maker will consider them to implement changes. And of course, this is only a summary of this information, and most detailed information can be found in the wiki space, which is linked to this this tool page. So this is taking me to the end of this lecture. So we have been through the different elements and challenges in the evaluation process for animal surveillance. We have been through the EVA decision tool, which has been developed trying to address all these challenges. And I just want to summarize again what are the critical steps in the evaluation process that are really important to advocate for changes. And again, this implies to have a very well-defined evaluation question. So you need to know exactly why you are doing an evaluation. But also, this is depending on a more broader context. So this also has to be taken into consideration. It is really important that the stakeholder and the right stakeholder are involved in the evaluation process. And of course, as you have seen, the evaluation needs to be tailor-made to be relevant to the specific context and needs. And also, the timing of the evaluation and the method to be used needs to be properly defined and considered. And also, ethics. So, I did not get through into details about that, but any evaluators is following some ethics. So, you can find on the evaluation wiki space some information on the evaluator best practices, which help the evaluator to follow this ethics. So what we have seen is that the EVA tool is promoting a structured approach to evaluation, which is based on providing sufficient information on the basic concepts that are available in as a summary in the tool, but more detailed in the wiki. But also expert advice, and also all this information is illustrated by examples in the wiki. But also, the tool is providing practical elements such as methods and reference, and we have developed this wiki space to ensure that this tool will be dynamic and will evolve with time, and especially will evolve based on the feedback and comments by users that will make it a very comprehensive tool and a platform gathering all the different important elements and information on the evaluation process. So this structured approach to evaluation allows for producing a documentation, maybe a standard report, or at least to ensure that every step of the process is documented, including the limits of the evaluation. And that allows for transparency and to promote and to advocate for changes again. And these changes can be done either by implementing a novel design. So the new design has been compared to the current one, and it would be interesting following the result of the evaluation to implement it. But it could also just emphasize the fact that the system needs some improvement and needs to be redesigned, or a new system needs to be designed. And of course, all these changes will also require at some stages to go back to the process of evaluation. So this is finalizing the cycle between surveillance design and evaluation and redesign. So I would like to thank you very much for your attention. This is the end of the lecture. You can find more information on the tool on the Evaluation Wiki space, which is at the moment not publicly available. You need to register as a member. And just also for information, at the moment, the evaluation tool is not available publicly, but it will be just following the end of the RiskScore project, which will be at the end of October. Thank you very much for your attention.